for us. And all I can feel is love, wonderful energy, and all I can feel is phenomenal. It's a feeling of family right across. So we're very, you know, in a new blessing as far as I'm concerned. I know some people were sort of concerned and have spoken about a bad day yesterday. No day is ever bad. Every day is absolutely perfect. I remember when I went to school at age 7 to learn about the Western world and to learn English. They told me that the day was terrible and I found out what it meant. So I shared it with the old people. They said there is no such day. Every day is absolutely perfect. Never take any day for granted. Never. Celebrate each day as it comes, so that yesterday I was celebrating because the evidence came in for us. When I was back at Waikato Mora, I was sitting there wondering what sort of evidence are coming in to let me know exactly how things are. It was brilliant sunshine back there. I drove up to Gisborne, and the sun was brilliant there, and then we had to fly down to Wellington. So for me, yesterday, I had to smile when I saw the rain. So celebrate it. Because every one of us is an eternal spirit having a physical journey. And so Rose will only come this way once, and it's at this particular time, so I believe in celebrating who I am. I have an eternal spirit. I speak to my spirit and say, it's all very well for you. You are eternal. You do not die. But me, the keeper, so help me. I would like to be Pandrat. So for me, it's just sharing the fact that we are celestial and terrestrial beings and that we are all related. The little one would see the language. I always identify with our ancient ancestors. Ngā Portugi, ngā huri a Maori. That waiata that I sang opens up the cosmos. Takurako. So that we could start this sharing. So that for me, I'm absolutely delighted to be here, to be sharing with you, and to celebrate alongside our whānau from here, who have certainly put it on for all of us. And it's wonderful. So for me, when I look at Te Pere, I think to myself, right, the three hearts. Aroha for us means, aro is the presence, ha is the breath. So aroha, the presence and the breath of our divine source, is unconditional love. And it's at that highest level. Quite often people, when they talk about love, that is not the love they are speaking about. So we need to get it right. Te Reo Rangatira is the language of the sun. The language of the sun, the central sun. So that for me, the ordinary meaning of Rangatira is esteemed person. But the sacred meaning is Ra, Ngati, Ra, which means we begin and end with the central sun. Ngati is the living breath of the central sun. So all of you, I welcome you as Ngati Ra, the living breath of the central sun. We are one family, and nothing but nothing can separate us. We are one. Talking about education, people like me could outrun our teachers because we were brought up as whole brain learners. And I realized when I went to school in the Western world, so help me, the teachers who were most of all, they were European, they were basically left brain. So I knew that if I wanted to be on their right side, I was shooting into their head brain.
But if I wanted to die them with destruction, I would link into the right, the intuitive, creative side. So help me, boys, what? So when you talk about education, I hope you know what they're talking about. Because for us, education involves the oneness of everything that exists. No separation, no division. And so for me, when I was teaching in the schools, and I don't know whether I have any ex-pupils here, but you know, they hated leaving after school. They wanted to stay. Why? Because we were teaching and sharing with each other. We were teachers and learners together. That was how we worked. We also worked on our program together. And even today I have grandparents who come to me to introduce their grandchildren because they remember me as a teacher who was right alongside them and was one with them. So that we worked together on whatever we had to share. The other one was that we link into Papa Tūnuku, Earth Mother. We're one with her. Waikato.
that trauma was coming from, and they picked up that it was in Japan. And they, first of all, they said, that energy has come from the United States, and they said, no, hold on. The energy actually comes in from New Zealand, because Lord Rutherford brought in the atom. So that's why I have trouble with my hip. It's because, in fact, I had some healing on me in 2011 in Hawaii. People come in to help remove some of it. So I'm saying to Papa Tunuku, kia kaha e kui! Kia piki te ora ki no te au koe! Kia piki te ora ki no te au! I want you to heal! Because that means we will all be healed. So, don't think that I limp just to get attention. It's because I'm one with Papa Tunuku. I am one with our mother. I'm one with the elements. I'm one with nature. I do not separate myself off from anything or anyone. So if you think that you can separate yourself away from me, forget it. I've got you, Tad. I'm enjoying it. So you see this book, Te Whiki, is used by all government agencies, universities, non-governmental organizations, and this book contains the teachings, the concepts from my own traditions, which go back over 12,000 years in terms of Hawaii Pāmamau, before a lot of it went underwater. So, this is not something that was just thought up. No, it has been trialed and tested for over 12,000 years. And so, people like me have produced, what a way to go, eh? We stand in our own power, we stand in our own mana. We are not programmed by the state or religion. Right? That's all of us. Step up. You've forgotten who you are. Hurry up and remember. So you can step up and be counted. So for me, I'm just delighted to see intergenerational sharing, because that's the world I come from. Every gathering we have involves at least four generations. And let me assure you that our children have as much say as anybody else. I was only 7 when I was making key decisions with the old people, and I would tell them straight. I was a pure channel for them. And when they made me sick, I made that clear too. So it makes me smile when people talk about children as if they don't know. No! Children have come in with the insight. They know where it's at. What we have to do is to encourage them to be able to stand in their own mana. So that was what I wanted to share. My grandson, Tahira, he's been very much involved with me over the years. They all are my grandchildren. I also have great-grandchildren. And they know that they, as far as I'm concerned, they have to get me to catch up in case I've forgotten something. Because I know they come in with the insight, and they are pure channels, as long as we recognize that. All right, let's get on to the eight dimensions. You heard me mention one, mana. Mana is your blessed authority from the divine source as well as your ancestors. So stand up with pride and celebrate your blessed authority. And don't ever be afraid to stand up. When you need to, mana. The other thing is that we are absolutely unique, every one of us. Every one of us who are present are absolutely unique. There has never been anyone like any one of us in this room, and there never will be. That is how important your mana is. The best of authority and the fact that you are a unique individual. So remember that, mana, M-A-N-A. Because when I hear some people talking about the eight tentacles, I can't believe it sometimes. I think, where on earth did they get that rubbish from? Because Tefege has been trialed and tested for over 12,000 years. Comes down from Portigi, and Maori are Maori. They were peacekeepers, they were vegetarian, and they always link into the pulse. Where is the pulse? It is the part of the planet or Papatūānuku that we know as New Zealand. This is Hawaiki Tauta, the pulse. And so, for me, just remember just how important it is to stand in your own mana, your own power, to be true to yourself, and to celebrate your absolute uniqueness. And just to remember that you are perfect. That's how I see you. Because I look at you and I never cease to be amazed to see just how different each one is. Even I had twin brothers, so help me. Identical twins, but they are still unique in their own right. And we know the difference between the two. So that's mana. All right? The next one. Wairua. Spirit, my spirit has two waters. One water is the water of life, everlasting, from the divine source. The other water records what I do, whether it be good or bad. So what I try to do is do better. If I do something wrong today, I forgive myself and try and do better tomorrow. So I talked to my spirit, and I told you that. Because the spirit is eternal, it is ancient, and our word for our spirit is kaumatu. But what has happened, our people are now using that to mean an elder. But it actually means our spirit, ancient spirit, is called a kaumatu. That's where that word comes from. Okay? So, spirit, celebrate who you are. And remember that we are eternal spirits having a physical journey. And so for me, my spirit is just part of me. And I don't know a world without the spiritual side. I really don't. I went to an Anglican boarding school so I could learn all about the Western world, learn about the Christian religion as such. And in the High Church of England, we had confession. How many of you realize that? Because most people think only Roman Catholics have confession. But the High Church of England does as well. So I used to go to confession. beautiful old man who reminded me of my old people. So I would make up my sins sometimes. Sometimes I would tell the truth, and so that I could spend time with Kenneth. And one Saturday night I said, Cannon, I have sinned. What is your sin, my dear? Gluttony. So, he told me to do penance at the back of the chapel. And then, you know, that was it. I could face the rest of the week. This was on a Saturday night. And I could take Holy Communion on the Sunday. And I enjoyed the wine. So, you had your right hand over your left. It's supposed to only take a little sip, but I just turn the cup off a bit, you know. And poor Cannon would be wrestling with me with the cup. But anyway, the second Saturday, what is your sin, my dear? And I said, gluttony. He just glared at me. The third Sunday, however, Samson, he said to me, look, I'm sick and tired of that sin of yours, and so is God. And instead of doing penance at the back of the chapel, you can go outside and sleep and surround. So I changed my sin. What am I sharing with you? I'm sharing with you the fact that in my world, we have a direct link in with the divine source. We do not separate ourselves. I'm sharing that one with you. So that's the way to do it. That's the spirit. Right, the next one. So how sin enters the physical world. Your body is absolutely sacred. And it is the micro of the macro, the universe itself. So you have a responsibility to look after your body. To the nth degree, to make sure that you're eating the right foods, all that. The head and the genital region particularly are very sacred. That is why I wear this on my head. Young people always put some down my head and told me never to let people touch my head. Because it is one of the most sacred parts of my body. So now you know why I wear this. And so if people had to touch my head, they had to ask for permission, right? Right, so for me, your body is a small universe. It's the micro of the macro. So I'm having trouble with the right side. I'm saying, okay, sort a few things out, Rose. But for me, I always say to myself, I'm getting better and better, stronger and stronger every day. Because I'm helping my body. Because the mind is very powerful. If you say, whoa, it's me. Oh, I'm getting old. What does that do to your body, for goodness sake? You work it out. Now, the mind is very, very powerful. So just remember that. So I want you to stand up because you look as if you're going to sleep. What's the time? I don't want to work overtime, people. What is it?
2:30.
2:30? Oh, well, I just about time to finish, but anyway. What I want you to do is to stand up and so we can do something. Kimber! Put now your hands on your hips, right? Have you got your hands on your hips? I've got beautiful hips, you know. Right, you follow me and you follow the actions, all right? Hands out! Come on! Say it!
Hands up!
Hands up!
One beside the other!
One beside the other!
Tikka, tikka, tikka,
tikka! Tikka, tikka!
to whanaungatanga. We say in the Western world, they talk about our social interaction, social side. Whanaungatanga to us covers the whole of humanity. We are one whānau in that we all get sustenance from our mother, Papa Tuanuku. And we are one family right across the world. So just remember, in terms of whanaungatanga, the social side of us, it's of no consequence if we can't remember just how we are one huge family right across. It doesn't matter what country I go to, as far as I'm concerned, the people of that country are family, they are whānau. The Egyptians are our closest in terms of the ancient people. The Egyptians are our patriarchal side, they're the right, and we are the left, the Maori. And so in Egypt, I would just look at these Egyptian men straight in the eye. And they couldn't believe it, because their women just don't do that. And they said, "Ooh, you strong woman." I said, "You got that right." "You the Queen of Sheba." I said, "You got that right." So today I have Egyptian whānau who send me gifts. This is from Egypt. And that's why I'm wearing it today. Because we're very close, and they send me gifts. But I was the same in Greece. "Oh, you Greek?" I said, "Oh, I might have a tiny bit of Greek, you know." And they would get me to get up to dance, and they would tell me to keep my hips still, you know, and just to move my shoulders. I found that tricky. So for me, no. We are whānau right across the world. And even where you might have someone, a mad relation of mine, he went to India, these are Matthew's relations over there. They're closer to him than they are to me. But this relation of mine, he saw this beggar in India. And he was supposed to be crippled and blind. And he had a big bag and was getting money. So my relation goes behind him, grabs the bag. He was up like a shot. And my relation said, "Yeah, you're just a thief." And they're both laughing. That's the Maori way. They both had a good laugh. Because for us, we are one. When we were in Egypt, I noticed the old people were hot, tired, and we were in the Valley of the Kings. We had been into a tomb. We came out. I said to Joe, "We had to help those old people get back to their buses, to the air conditioning." And he looked at me and said, "Oh, what on earth is she going to do, you know?" So I called out to those people, "Hey, haramai! Daki haramai!" I thought any fool knows what that means. So they did. They came up to me. Then I turned around and faced the buses. And I sang Maori Battalion, and so they marched behind me. "Maori Battalion march to victory. Maori Battalion staunch and true. Maori Battalion march to glory. Take the honor of the people with you. We will march, march, march to the enemy. We will fight, fight to the end. For God, for King, and for country." Oh, they marched back to their buses. And because I sang in English, they called out, "More! More!" That's whanaungatanga. All right? So that's the fourth dimension. So just remember that we're one. Number five, let's have a look. I'm trying to remember these eight bits. Eight dimensions. Hi, Akihira. the mental, the intellectual side of us. She is the hidden mother. She has two children. Rongo is the light brain. And Rongo is the intuitive, creative side of us. And Rongo links into the left side, to Tamawahine, the mother energy. Tumatoenga is the left brain. And Tumatoenga, the brother, the son of Hiningaro, links into Tamatane, the right side. And when we get the two brains working together, we get Tane Maurangi, and we can reach that highest level in terms of the super consciousness. So you see how people like myself could outrun not only our teachers, but I was the same in education. We could outrun our colleagues, most of them, because they were basically left brain, and they were used to just working with that and not using both. So for us, Hiningaro is the hidden mother in all of us, and she has two children. We personify everything so that we remember. So just think about that. My left side is the rational, logical side, but I very much love my right side, the intuitive, creative, mischievous side, as far as I'm concerned. No. So that for us, Hiningaro. So think about that. Education, come on, get your whole brain working. Those songs that you sing, another song that I have sung right across the world too, is Hutia Te Rito. And I use my whole brain to get the tune and to get the words that I wanted. Because you need to use the whole brain to do that. So that's Hiningaro. Next one, hurry up. We've already done Fanangatanga.
Tahatinana.
We've done that. The body. Maori, life force, life principle. For example, the marae that we went on to yesterday. Oh, was it yesterday? Or this morning? No, it was this morning. Maori has a very strong life force. Maori is a life force, ethos that we have within us. When we die physically, the Maori changes status. It becomes an awe. And we had to ensure that the Maori and the Wairua go home together in terms of the person who has passed over. So Maori is a life force. It's in the trees, it's in the rocks, it's in everything that exists. Everything has its own life force, its own Maori. And for me, Maori comes in and it's unique to you. The Wairua is not unique to you. Your Wairua, your spirit has many keepers. It's had eons of keepers over time. Sometimes I see past keepers of my spirit. So remember that. The spirit you have has been held by other keepers. A keeper is a person like Rose. I am the keeper of my eternal spirit, and I know the name of my eternal spirit. I won't tell you, but it has been held by many people in the past. And so when I travel the world and interact with 150 plus nations, I can tune in on the whole because of being there, done that, in terms of my spirit. But the Maori is different. The Maori is unique to me. When I came in on into this world, the Maori came in for me specifically, for Rose. Some of you might call that a soul. I don't, you know, it doesn't worry me too much what you call it. But for me, my Maori is the one that truly links into Rose and is the one that I really take care of in my own way. Okay? So we've got mana, taha tinana, hiningaro, whanangatanga. Here's the other one, whatu manawa. Whatu manawa is the emotional side of us. For me as a Māori, we believe in expressing emotion. Not keeping it, you know, for example, my colleagues in education, when they first went with me onto the marae, to a tangi, to a funeral, and for those of you who don't know our culture as such, we wail right on top of our voices to help to bring the trauma out of the family that have just lost a loved one. So whatu manawa for us is the all-seeing eye of the heart. It's the emotions. And we believe in expressing emotion rather than repressing it. And I remember my colleagues in education saying, if you move from one extreme emotion to the other, you are having a nervous breakdown. So I said to them, hey, I need 6 months leave. They said, what on earth for, Rose? I said, I'm having a nervous breakdown. They said, what? I said, you told me that if we move from one extreme emotion to the other, we are having a nervous breakdown. You have seen me on the marae. One minute I'm laughing. Next minute I'm crying. You've seen it. So, I'm taking leave. They said, no way, Rose, you know. So, these are some of the things that are a part of me. They're a part of our culture. And I assess myself and see, okay, Rose, how is your whatu manawa? How are your emotions today? Because the old people always told us, be very careful with your thoughts, be very careful with your words, because they can manifest. You know that in Māori we do not have any swear words, none. So I have to turn to English, don't I? We certainly haven't got them in Māori. Penis of a dog, pothead. You're stupid beyond belief. They don't quite work for me when I'm raving mad and really angry. So I switch over to English. I don't now. I've told my grandchildren to find me $2 for every word I use that is negative, so that I learn to control my tongue, to keep my words perfect and my thoughts perfect, okay? Challenge. And that's our beautiful human side. You know, my husband who passed over in 2012, we were happily married for 52 years. And sometimes I would, you know, get stuck into him. And I would say, you know, my divine side would never do this to you, Joe. But this is the human side. So there's a way out, you know what I mean? So, what, we must only have one or what?
Now
Taonga Tuku Iho. What? Taonga Tuku Iho, yes. Those are the treasures from our ancestors that we uphold and we celebrate. We celebrate the way that we welcome people onto the marae, the way we look after our guests. For me, I come from a family where you see and you serve the people and you make sure you look after everybody else. You come last. That's the world I come from. Tonga tiku iho, our cultural treasures, culture. I love our songs. I love our haka. Ki mai koe tu hoa kai a koe tonu te pito te aroha. Iya ha ha. Kia hiko aue. Te oka oka o takupu. Kia hiko aue. Kei hinga aue. Kei mate aue. Kei kakata hei. Right? They build up our energy. I chose to be a Maori in this lifetime because, on the whole, we're absolutely fearless. And we have a warrior stance. And sometimes we need a warrior stance in terms of fighting for what is right. And not being afraid to stand up and be counted when you need to be. So, for me, I treasure the teachings, I treasure all, for me, the gifts that have come down from our ancestors. And when I travel the world, that is what I rely on, is I rely on, like singing Mighty Battalion, because of whanaungatanga, but it's also part of our culture. It's cultural. So we celebrate our culture as well as anything else. So that for me, I am saying to our people, make sure that you uphold our culture, our traditions on the marae. Don't let other people do it. You have a responsibility to do the karanga, to be the speakers on your marae, on your courtyard. You know what marae actually means? It means the forehead. It's the forehead of the house. The house is likened to the brain. You have rongo on the right side of the house. You have two matawinga on the left. And the brand of the house is called Te Rolo o Te Whare. It is the brain of the house. Marae, rai, is your forehead. Rae, links directly into the central sun. For us, our vibrations are very important. That is the vibration of the Divine Mother. Let me hear you. Again. That is the vibration of the Divine Mother. The vibration of the Divine Child. But it's pronounced E, okay? Now the vibration of the Divine Father. Oh! Ano? The vibration of Papa Tumuku is U, U. Hey! Now those are our vowel sounds, and they are the vibrations that we link into. You heard the word a-io up there today. Ordinary meaning peace. Sacred meaning is a vibration of the Divine Mother, which is on our left, Divine Child in the center, and Divine Father. The word kia ora, ordinary meaning, we use it for a greeting. But sacred meaning is the K is subtle energy that brings in these energies for us, for kia ora. And then you have the vibration of the Divine Child, the Divine Mother, the Divine Father in kia ora from Ra, the central sun. That is how come we link into the Egyptians. We both link into the central sun. So now you know, when you hear those vibrations, what they stand for. But you see, we talk about the whole three. Tamat Vahine, left side. Tamaroto Tamaiti, the child in the center. Tamatane is on the right-hand side. So when you say kia ora, just remember what it means. It's not only a greeting, it means the Divine Child, Divine Mother, Divine Father from the central sun. So that our language, the language of the sun, has hidden meaning. I haven't had time to go through it. I'm writing a book. So while I'm talking about writing my book about the Tohunga and sharing these teachings, I've got two boxes of books over here with Te Whiki. Now, one box is for our whānau here, the kaupapa. Cost you $30 a book. So, as I've said, 50% of the books that are sold, 50% goes to our whānau here, 50% for me to help me publish the next book, which is about my role as a tohunga. And while I'm about it, we had 4 Maori MPs who brought in the Tohunga Suppression Act. Well, I'm still going anyway. So I'm writing, I am in the process, I've almost completed my book. So I want you to know that half the proceeds of the book go to our whānau here, and the rest will help me to publish, because I want to be the publisher. Get a printer to do the job, all right? Well, I think I've covered everything. Ne? Any questions? What's the time?
2 minutes to 3.
2 minutes to 3? You got 2 minutes. Kanui aroha, everybody. You're always welcome to visit me at Waikare Mona, but don't come at the same time. All you have to do is say, where's Auntie Rose? If you ever go to Waikare Mona, and you'll be able to link in with me. But it's been my pleasure to come down to link in with you, and I'm looking forward to hearing from, you know, the rest of our whānau here. So, ka nui te aroha. And we'll just sing a-io. It has been translated into many languages, but we'll sing, you know, that one to conclude today. So you'll have to stand up to do that to help me. Normally we do it on our own, but today you help me. Anei te hira. Hope. Ai o timata. Ai o.
Nō reira, I rungi I tō kōrero rangatira, tēnā koe. Ka hara mai nei e te aku ārongo. Ki te hoatu te tahi taonga kia koe. Nō reira, hara mai koutou. Koina te kōrero I tēnei wā. The kōrero that Fire Rose has given today, anei he taonga e rite tonu ki tēnā. So the taonga that they are giving today is a reflection of the kōrero. It's a taonga that has been done by a renowned painter in this region, by Robin Slow. Nō reira, hō mai te pakipaki anō mō a tātou kuia.
Links into the divine spark, Father Energy.